We will have a beautiful meditation piece. It's a little under 3 minutes long. Music and lyrics by the master Peter Dunoff. This song is titled, I Can Love. And the translation of the lyrics. I can love to become kind. I can be affectionate to become strong. Love and affection will teach me how to become a servant of God. Becoming a servant is the new field of action that will generate love. A new world is being created where love and affection reign and truth triumphs. Then life becomes free. We've just completed recently 33 weeks of the Hour of Truth with the Master Hilarion. Within this quote, a new world is being created where love and affection reign and truth triumphs. We understand that for truth to triumph, love and affection must reign first. Therefore, to counteract the lie, untruth, all deception, deceit, lying, we can choose to generate this divine love in a new field of action in order to help bring about the triumph of truth where all men, women, and children are free. What better way to engage in the alchemy whereby truth may reign, truth may triumph, save to be expressive of this pure and affectionate love. Love first toward God, love toward ourselves, and love toward every being and every creature. Yes, I can love to become kind. I can be affectionate to become strong. And this love and this affection will teach me how to become a servant of God. Now, in our Jesus Great Commandment Prayer 0.000, remember that we added, after I am loving the Lord my God with all my heart, mind, strength, and soul, we added, I am serving the Lord my God. So we do love in order to become servitors, servants of the Most High God, by serving our fellow brothers and sisters, serving our communities, serving our planet, serving life. And this service is the new field of action, because in serving, you have to love. By giving and serving, we are expressing love actively. Service is love made manifest through work. Last night we had a servitors meeting of the Heart Center community, those who are engaged in service in any capacity within our movement as servitors. Lonello had a great teaching that he presented to us. And within that teaching, there was a challenge for us to resolve any conflict we have with a particular person or persons by doing Ho'oponopono for 33 days. And holding that person or persons in our consciousness, in our mind, in our heart, and calling upon those sacred words, I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. In whatever order you choose to give those sacred words of the Ho'oponopono prayer. And by doing this, what do we generate? We generate this field, a new field of action, a new field of divine love, that will help resolve any untoward relationships that we have or may have with any individual and within ourselves. And by our self-resolution, guess what happens? Affection and love begin to reign, R-E-I-G-N, and also R-A-I-N, in our world. And that love will dissolve the cause and core of that conflict, and truth, the higher truth of divine wisdom, will triumph. I can love to become kind. Will I love to become kind? That is our choice. I can be affectionate to become strong, yet we must translate that possibility, that capability, into action to make it so, make it a reality. I will love to become kind. And ultimately, we translate that to I am love. I am kindness. I am affectionate. I am strong. We learned in conscious language that can is great, yet I am is better. It brings it into the present moment of fulfillment within the universal, eternal now. I am a new field of action. I am generating love. I am the new world that I am creating because I am love and I am affection, and these reign now, even as I am truth and truth triumphs. I am life. I am free. I am freedom. Even with the words of a great master such as Peter Dunov, knowing the truths that we know of the I Am teachings, we can even take his teaching and make it front, center, and present in our lives through affirmations using the name of God I Am, and make it even more powerful, more dynamic, because we have assimilated it by our consciousness wed to spirit. Spirit becoming tangible, physical flesh through action, through work, through service. If we are truly affectionate toward everyone and everything, will there be conflict? If the affection is true and real and authentic, yes. If it's feigned, if it's just surface, then no, there will still remain subconscious patterns, a scotoma, a blind spot within that will not endear us to one another in the most meaningful and divine way. So if you truly dislike someone, even if you try to love them, will you resolve the conflict? Affection is liking and drawing ourselves to that person. Yet, what do we draw ourselves to? The I am within us is drawn to the I am within them. The real within us is drawn and magnetized to the real within them. We can overlook the human, or we can choose to simply love everything about the person, even their imperfections. Love the imperfection. You don't endear yourself to it in the sense that you become it, yet eventually even the seeing of that imperfection dissolves and all you see is light, love, and the divine within them. And then the real conflict is truly resolved because seeing is believing. What you believe through seeing clearly, perfectly, divinely, intimately in love with God within yourself and the other and God everywhere, then the resolution process fully blossoms and manifests because there's no more discord. There's no more unclear seeing that then magnetizes unreality to you and foists it upon another or fosters it in a relationship. True divine affection is a beautiful thing when it flows from the source of love within you, who is God. True divine affection is a beautiful thing when, through an empathic attempt to understand another, you walk in their moccasins, first in your consciousness and maybe even physically. Why are they the way they are? Obviously because of life choices. And if I had been in the same situation, what would I look like? Who would I be? Maybe I would be worse off than they and their personality and the way that they rub me wrong sometimes. Coming into a deep psychological resolution and understanding of what makes a person who they are is part and parcel to also resolving our own psychology, because we are ultimately all one. And what we see in another, we have within ourselves. Clear the beam within ourself and the little mote, the little iota of almost nothingness that we see within another will also be dissolved. We will actually help the person more by believing and seeing the best, the divine within them. We will actually help them, and then we will be happy because there's no more part of them that we dislike. It's a very simple process if you think about it, and yet we complicate it through reactivity, nastiness, and how we treat people, even within our minds and within our emotional body. What I see as more important than just the words we speak or how we relate outwardly is the inner impulses and how we actually feel about someone and have that self-talk about them that is problematic. If our divine self-talk, if we choose to translate and transmute that inner divine self-talk or self-talk and make it divine, then by choosing to observe the divine and saying, I am in love with the divine within this person, I am the perfect resolution of my issues with this person. Then an amazing alchemy takes place and the reactivity will dissolve. The duality will be consumed and erased. We enter into the non-dual state of beingness within our presence. And from that pure point, the singularity of our God self, realized state, we love all life free. The last statement in this prayer and song, then life becomes free. If we really choose to be free, to associate with this love and affection, we will understand this dynamic. We will involve ourselves in this alchemy of becoming strong in our affection and love, of becoming a servant of God, of generating this new field of action where love is present. Love is possible. Love is real. I think that as initiates of the Ascended Masters within our community, we have to be psychologists of spirit and understand our psyche, our soul, and go deeper and deeper within to cleanse ourselves and ferret out those things which yet remain allowing us to live in mortality through our human personality rather than to live in a divine estate of beingness in God's presence through love. As we resolve our psychology, do that deep work day after day where we self-assess, we go within in meditation, in our spiritual practices, and completely root out every vestige of hatred, mild dislike, anger, untoward reactions, we will make such great progress that the magnetic quality of divine love that we will generate collectively will then translate also as the growth of our community. Not that we are so concerned about growth in numbers. We're more concerned about growth in terms of the aura of divine love that we collectively emanate through our authentic lives lived to God's glory. Living in the glory of God is living in the love of God. Living in the Shekinah of the Divine Mother is living in the eternality of perfected love, charity, and the constancy of how that love may be expressive in our daily lives, hour by hour, moment by moment. The Master Dunov was a great psychologist, and he saw into the very souls of men, women, and children, just as Mark Prophet did and other great seers who could witness to what people were thinking, feeling, because the aura was observable, and within the aura, an initiate can see all that is transpiring. Now, we don't focus on being able to see the aura, but all of us feel the auras of others and of the world at large. And through our intuition, we may know through a deeper sense, an extrasensory perceptive sense of cosmic understanding that comes if we are still, if we have learned the science and the art of silence and stillness. If you desire to develop greater intuitional skills, learn and master the art of meditation and deep stillness, because in listening grace is where you will hear what heaven desires you to know, what spirit is speaking unto you, what your intuition, your conscience already knows about others and every situation. It's all there, vibrating in the ethers. Can we pick up on it? Can we read it? only if we are clear first. And so our work is mainly and primarily about keeping clear, clearing ourselves through the use of the violet light, Ho'oponopono, all the prayers, decrees, the right diet, the right spiritual and solar sciences that we engage in. And as we are clearer and clearer, everything will be refocused into a higher field, this beautiful field of action where we generate love. We're going to play this now one more time. And with this understanding and looking upon the beautiful artwork of Slavka Kolsar, one of the two daughters of the beautiful messenger of light, Natasha Kolsar, who began the Ideal Society in Canada, you can see that love expressed between the two beings in this watercolor work by Slavka, and what it generates above them, above their crown chakras, almost like a tree of life, like a giant leaf with many colors and many things happening there, possibilities for their future as they unite together as one affectionate and loving couple. So go deeper now into the visual, go deeper into the music, and feel these words, and we'll see what happens in our lives for the rest of this week and beyond as we are expressive of this deep divine love and affection toward others and ourselves and all life.